The Dig is a poignant historical drama starring Carey Mulligan, Ralph Fiennes, Lily James and Johnny Flynn that charts an archaeological find in the English countryside on the eve of World War II. The film is an adaptation of John Preston's novel, also called The Dig, which was published in 2007. But is it based on a true story? And did The Dig really happen? The answer is a definite yes. While some of the story has been changed to bring it to life on screen, the most important elements of The Dig are absolutely true. The timing, the people, and the discoveries and implications of The Dig itself. Let's take a look, starting with the story's central characters. The Dig stars Ralph Fiennes as a local excavator and archaeologist called Basil Brown, a humble man whose work is crucial in uncovering the treasure of Sutton-Hoo.
I'm Basil Brown, excavator.
This matches the accounts of Brown in real life. He was born in 1888 in a village near Ipswich, and though he left school at 12 to work on his father's farm, he was a self-taught geologist, astronomer, and geographer. He learned Latin and published a book on astronomy before starting work for Ipswich Museum, undertaking archaeological research across the county. He really did rely on his bicycle as a principal form of transport, and in real life, just as in the film, he was married to May.
I found that ship. I may not be a fellow at Cambridge, but I worked out what was down there. And nobody will remember that.
You don't know that. And if you're not around to see it to the end, there's even less chance.
Carey Mulligan, meanwhile, stars as Edith Pretty, the widow and mother upon whose land the burial mounds are located, and who arranges for Basil Brown to start excavation. This, too, is all accurate. Pretty was a little older than Mulligan. Born in 1883, she was in reality 5 years the senior of Brown, and had given birth to her son Robert at the age of 47. She married Lieutenant Colonel Frank Pretty in 1926, a year after the death of her father, and Frank himself passed away in 1934. It was her idea to dig. She had travelled widely in her youth, visiting Pompeii and the pyramids, and as mentioned in the film, her father had excavated a Cistercian abbey next to her childhood home, all of which helped to explain her impulse to investigate the mounds at Sutton-Hoo.
My interest in archaeology began like yours when I was scarcely old enough to hold a trowel.
The surrounding cast of characters we see in the film is also full of real people. Stuart Piggott and his wife Peggy, played on screen by Ben Chaplin and Lily James, were among the first experts to arrive at the site when the scale of the dig began to escalate.
This is my wife, Margaret.
Peggy!
Peggy really was the first to discover gold during the excavation, and both of them would go on to have distinguished careers in the archaeological field. Incidentally, Peggy is important to the film for another reason. Author John Preston only began researching the story that would form the basis of the novel adapted into the film when he learned that Peggy was his aunt. And the characters of Charles Phillips and Reed Moore, bustling academics whose dynamic gives some insight into the clamour for credit and access that surrounded the dig, were also both very much real people. Played by Paul Reddy, Moore was a fellow of the Royal Society and president of Ipswich Museum.
We hope that you'll agree that the Ipswich Museum is the perfect place
for another time.
A local archaeologist of some standing, who clashed with the equally real Phillips, played by Ken Stott, who arrived from Cambridge University to take charge of the excavation when its importance was established.
Don't let her give it to Ipswich. The British Museum will buy everything.
Perhaps most interestingly, not only are the people accurately portrayed, but so is the dig itself. Here's an aerial view of how the actual site looks today, where you can see the mounds, with Tranmer House in the background and also a view of the river, along which the burial ship was carried before being dragged to its ceremonial position. In the film, coming conflict with Germany looms over events in idyllic-looking Suffolk, often literally, with RAF planes frequently seen overhead.
Judging by last night's news, I think we could be at war in a matter of weeks.
This lends the story a tremendously powerful sense of digging into the past while on the precipice of an uncertain future. Our characters caught at a moment of reflection and change.
This country is at war with Germany.
And it's absolutely true. The inquest into the rightful ownership of the dig's finds was held in August 1939, and Britain declared a state of war with Germany in September. The dig and its discoveries were really every bit as important as the film suggests. This is partly because of the scale and quality of the finds. Hundreds of items, including Byzantine silverware, gold jewellery, ornate fighting gear, and more, but also because of the period they're from. Dated to the early 7th century, the Sutton-Hoo burial mound shone a light on a period of history previously known as the Dark Ages, as it was thought to mark a slide back into primitivism after the Romans left Britain.
Talk about Dark Ages, I can hardly see my pint.
According to Dr. Sue Brunning, curator at the British Museum, Sutton-Hoo helped explode that myth forever.
The Dark Ages are no longer dark.
This single burial in a pretty corner of Suffolk, she said, embodied a society of remarkable artistic achievement, complex belief systems, and far-reaching international connections, not to mention immense personal power and wealth. It's regarded as the most important archaeological find in Britain, and perhaps even the world.
This is Anglo-Saxon.
By Jupiter! 6th century! This changes everything.
Shortly after the inquest, which ruled that all the items found in the Sutton-Hoo burial mound lawfully belonged to Edith Pretty, Pretty donated the entire collection to the British Museum. It's among the most valuable donations of its kind, and the collection itself remains at the heart of the museum, the helmet found during the dig an icon of learning and history, familiar to millions of visitors from around the world. The Dig is available to watch on Netflix from the 29th of January, 2021.